widely believed to be the first Gothic novel, establishing a blueprint for a dark literary genre that was obsessed with terror, death, and the supernatural. The Victorian traditions of ghost stories during the Christmas season created a genre of its own, which is best represented by A Christmas Carol by Charles Dickens. In the pages of the 19th century's penny dreadful books to the pulp magazines of the 1920s and 30s, ghost stories have always been a part of our popular culture. In those days, just like today, many of the most popular stories, plays, and presentations were based on real life. Truth is, as they say, always stranger than fiction. Having fun with the spirit world. When news spread of the knockings in Hydesville, New York, the Fox sisters became almost instant celebrities. For details on the Fox sisters and their stories, see Chapter 2. The newspapers and the public couldn't get enough of them. The spiritualist movement swept across the country, even in those days before radio, television, and mass communication. People became obsessed with the idea that the living could communicate with the dead and receive a reply, and almost everyone wanted to be involved with it. By the early 1850s, an estimated 2 million spiritualists were in the United States, and the movement showed no signs of slowing down. It was easy to find people from the lowliest tenement homes to the very steps of the White House who believed in contact with the spirits. It was a time of prominence for some of America's greatest literary celebrities, all of whom also had a great effect on the popular culture of the country. Almost all of them expressed curiosity for the growing spiritualist craze. Writing about the spirits. In The Haunting of America, authors William J. Burns and Joel Martin revealed that many 19th century celebrities were fascinated by the spirit world. Ralph Waldo Emerson was a transcendentalist who believed in the afterlife. This movement taught that divinity can be found in all nature and humanity. Henry Wadsworth Longfellow shared his views. Henry David Thoreau, also a transcendentalist, expressed interest in reincarnation. William Cullen Bryant took part in seances, and so did Nathaniel Hawthorne, who then rejected spiritualism, but created a spiritualist character for his 1852 novel, The Blithedale Romance. Throughout his life, he acknowledged that he had witnessed apparitions. In one incident, Hawthorne, who often went to the Boston Athenaeum, the research library in the city, always noticed an elderly minister there reading. One evening, as usual, Hawthorne saw the same gentleman in his usual chair. He was stunned to learn that the man had already died before he saw him. Hawthorne concluded that he had seen the man's ghost, which continued to appear for several more weeks. Herman Melville, author of the 1851 book Moby Dick, was a believer in the afterlife. Walt Whitman understood phrenology, an occult science based on the measurements of the skull, well enough to allude to it in his poetry. Later in the century, Henry James included spiritualists in his books, and the creator of Sherlock Holmes, Sir Arthur Conan Doyle, became one of the greatest proponents of spiritualism in history. The popular English poet Elizabeth Barrett Browning, drawn to spiritualism, joined in seances conducted by the famed medium Daniel Douglas Hume. However, her husband, Robert Browning, despised Hume.